called All the Fishy People. First, let's do this though. Let's distract ourselves from the horrors of the dead fish town.
There's no time to waste. There's no time at all.
I think I've got to fight everything here. Kill or be killed. Okay, priority. Eyeball. You keep hitting him back in the head. Maybe that isn't the priority. Whoa! The problem is he's getting a range on me that I don't like. Okay. Maybe he isn't priority then. Maybe Mr. Ruin is priority. Let's see if we can get over here and get away from them. Damn it! If I don't get this, by the way, I don't think I get a chance to repeat it. Wow, he did a long run up there. I'm not really doing the best job here, am I? I think you got a set. I think the tea got a hit on me there. Ah! Sorry for yelling like a little baby there. That was rather scary. This is nasty. No way! I think actually we can get him. Whoa, that was bad. I heard him coming. I heard him like chung 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 coming across the battlefield. I forgot how fast they can rush. Are you kidding me? Come on. I was dodging at the last second there. Yeah, I'd like to continue. I might be able to do it again. I'm not sure. Maybe. Okay, I can. Right. I'm gonna try this again. No. damn it. Going so well. So the key appears to be using the grinder to kill these guys at a distance. I forgot. I'm so used to the usual method of, you know, you shoot the eyeball in the teapot in the eyeball. Then you go and stab him. I've forgotten that you can just shoot him in the eye. This has been a long old fight. Partly due to twice I've had eye bots that have somehow become invincible. I don't know how, but I haven't been able to shoot them anymore in the eye, which is a bit weird. But there you go. It's fun at any rate, and it's not as nasty as the nightmare mode. This, hopefully this is, oh blimey, that was a well-deserved rose, really. That was one hell of a fight. Took me quite a while to get that, just to get an extra rose. There we go. I think there's one more I can get in the game, but that was pretty brutal. Pretty brutal. A well-deserved heart. What do you call it? A well-deserved rose. Right, now let's go back to where I was, and we'll go see how Fishtown's doing. By the way, not well. Very badly indeed. Yeah, the fishies. Oh! Even the snout is dead. Because we have a dead snout. I don't remember that. We've got a ghost snout. Okay, we'll go and get that. We'll go and get that now. Good stuff. Anything else around here? Any more ghost things? You know what's even more disturbing than these poor dead creatures all been eviscerated and stabbed and hung up in various cruel ways? Can you hear? Look at that. Why would you do that? That's horrible. In the eyes and everything. There are some creatures still alive.
Every picture tells a story. Sometimes we don't like the ending. Sometimes we don't understand it.
It's a cuttlefish with a... Is he a cuttlefish? No, he's a nautilus with a saw through his head, and then they've put his hat back on again. Sorry, Alice. Put his hat back on again afterwards. Why have they killed them all? I mean, what was the purpose? The carpenter built the town, presumably to lure the fish in. But to what end? I mean, what is the point of this slaughter? He hasn't eaten them. What is the point of all this slaughter? That's horrible, isn't it? It's absolutely horrible. And that, is that a little kid? See, look, he's been cut open and his insides opened up like that. See, you can pin down. Horrible. Absolutely horrible. I don't know where this has come from. Maybe, I mean, the Victorians were big on medical advances. I think I'm going to go up here first. And they did do a lot of vivisections, and they did a lot of... anything over here? Got to figure something out here. Like the way it's designed... No, can't get out there. Vivisections and anatomy studies, which is very important for the learning of medicine, but gruesome stuff, I guess. I don't know. I don't know where this has come from. What's this over here? They're that way, so let's not go that way. Is there anything else we can get to? Anything else we can find before we go and confront the carpenter and the walrus? Murdering scum. Oh, look. Someone's still alive. The bottlefish and the octopus are still alive. What have you got to say for yourself? Nothing, apparently. Maybe the actual performance hasn't started yet. We're still waiting. We still have the... Yeah, they're in the audience. They haven't discovered about the fishies yet, I guess. Or... Well, there are some still fish alive in here. Lovely.
Ladies and gentlemen,
what a treat you're all in for.
Welcome to the show!
Yuck. That's also rather disturbing.
This is our show.
Yeah.
That's quite enough of that, I think. Enough preliminaries. Here's the performance you've been waiting for. Proves I'm without prejudice and have a fine sense of humour.
He sighed.
Sword and crown are worthless here. I invite everyone to dance. Labourers, lawyers, church and gown all make their little prance. This life is full of random deaths and heaps of grief and shame. So if you are sued by accident, you want someone to blame. Fire, plague, and strange disease. Drowned, murdered, or if you please. A long fall down the basement stairs. None are expected. No one cares. I often must work very hard. Sweat running down my skin. After the dance, I then must rest. And the eating can begin. Time to eat. Death is the ultimate equalizer. All have the right to be eaten.
Get a knife, Princess. Don't push. All will be served.
So to speak.
Wicked thing. Feasting while Wonderland is destroyed.
I'm not the enemy you seek, Alice. I tried to hide this bit of Wonderland from that beast. Appeasement's never clean. We must all play our assigned roles. Are you a pawn or a queen? An idiot or a practiced fool? However this turns out, consider the prospect that you've been misled, Alice. Then ask, by whom?
No! Who set that bloody train in motion? Where has it come from?
It arrived when you arrived, and it's more horrible even than you could currently imagine. The death of a dream! Caterpillar may know how!
Death of a dream, huh?
What? The blood in my mouth tastes like bile. Where's the brute that hit me, Nanny?
Nasty Pratt's out cold. Not dead, and more's the pity.
What did he want?
What they all want. Money didn't earn. What were you thinking, butting into that mess? You could have been killed.
Nanny, my mind's in pieces. I still have terrible visions, and I need to know.
About the fire. Same as always. You need to move on, Alice. So do I. Well, at least she's not spewing that asylum nonsense. My past is dead. I killed them. I should have saved them. I should have died. Her mind was in shambles. Radcliffe thought familiar faces would bring her round. After a year, he lost interest in her inheritance. Greedy sod. Still, always asking his bizarre questions. Heavy dose of madness, I'd say, but honesty is never the best policy in this life. When she wasn't comatose, she gaped, eyes like pinwheels, drooled, occasionally squeaked. Never uttered a sensible sound. And like the child she was, she kept her secrets close. Gone-offs and lurkers, common as cockroaches. And those poor tykes are food for perverts, like the blameless ants that wasps consume or spiders' feeble prey.
You visited my room at Rutledge. What were you...
You recall that? Radcliffe paid me. For a bit. A woman alone sometimes does what she doesn't particularly feel like doing. As you know.
Nurse Whitler said you'd fallen on hard times.
I'm no drunk like her. I'm hurting no one. Hookin's not a bad life.
Except for the pimps. She also said you might have my rabbit. Please, Nanny, talk about...
The damn fire never seems to help. Look, Alice, I can't give you what I don't have. Radcliffe wrote the inquest report. I'll take you to him. Besides, he's got your damn rabbit. You should remember that.
all right, but Mr. Redcliffe's useless.
Don't I know it?
So here we are, yes, and back to the real world again. The death and destruction that the carpenter and the walrus have upon Barrel Bottom has then been trumped by the train coming through and smashing everything, and the death of a dream. And now we have I can't actually remember this part very well. We have poor old Nanny now, who is as a now fallen on hard times. Crabsworth Goods and Trading. And is now hooking. She's been a hooker for the thing. Oh, we're in a slightly nicer part of town here. This lady's a bit nicer dressed. We've seen the horrors of what happened to some of the poor children around here. I presume we're going to go, as we're in a better part of town, we're going to go and try and find Radcliffe.
Bear to the ground, Bill.
Yeah, I've been scouting around. Nothing in a minute. Place is crawling with rozzers since them bleeding murders.
Whose work was that?
You want to know that sort of thing? You've got to know where to listen.
Bit shy today, ain't
you? I ain't you, dicky bird. Do your own fagging leg work.
I say this older gentleman doesn't really have the right accent for that, for what he's talking about there. But it's been murders going on, have they? Interesting. In a nice part of town like this. Look at him, very finely dressed, young and older.
I'd be glad to shake your hand, sir.
Considering the nature of the goods on offer, it seems more than generous.
You do know the way to a girl's heart, don't you? And unless you open your purse a little wider, that's all you're going to get.
Well, I'm sure we can work something out. You might get more if you stop talking.
Consider my lips sealed.
Oh no, dear. That wouldn't do at all.
Oh God. Higher class hookers, but still hookers. And the way to a girl's heart. How rude he was being to her. Oh no, have I skipped a bit? That's a shame. Wilton J. Radcliffe, solicitor. I actually wanted to go the other way and have a look around, but never mind. Give me my bunny back.
Yes? Who is it?
Alice Liddell, Mr. Radcliffe.
Ah, you're back. I suppose you better come up. Mind the latch.
What a nice place. Now, Mr. Radcliffe, to explain some of the surroundings you're about to see, has visited the Orient many times. And there's some beautiful things here. Look at these lovely vases. Things of beauty. Come up. So I presume he's upstairs. Let's have a wander downstairs then. What a lovely place. Is he in here? Lovely fretwork screens. Looking for some nice blue and white. Oh, there we go. A green jade teapot. A lovely green colour there. And the blue and white. That was The Secrets of Porcelain. And the blue. A nice top hat. The pure whiteness and thinness of porcelain and the blue colouring was a secret for a long time. It took people in Britain a very long time, a lot of study, to try and work out how it was made. All down to the sort of clay that you use. These swords here. Radcliffe, who can make even fascinating subjects boring, says the curved blade is a 12th century Maitu katana, and the shorter sword is called a wakizashi, both used by Japanese samurai. Indeed. Look at that lovely blue and white. Zhuand porcelain, Mr. Radcliffe's F, is the Ming Dynasty's finest. Beautiful shapes, best colours, and most prized decorations. Yes. I presume that's a Chinese dynasty. But I don't know. There he is. Gotta go in here. No, I can't go in there. And lovely fans and things as well. There's me bunny.
You do have my rabbit.
Forgotten your manners? And what else, I wonder? You abandoned it at Rutledge Asylum, my dear. We've been over this before.
In a huff as usual, oozing with attitude and accusatory flummery, I've stolen her rabbit. Ridiculous pretext. She's here about the fire again. All the mad child wants to talk about. My report found her family dead by misadventure. She won't accept it. It goes on and on about her killing memories and her need to know the truth. The alleged truth is, the fire began in the library when the cat knocked over a lamp. The blaze trapped her parents and sister upstairs. Sister Lizzie never even unlocked her door, died in her bed. The guilty cat always sets her off. She denies it, makes no sense, it can't be, etc. Agreed. From the outset, Alice was my candidate for the pyromaniac. The girl had a fixation with fire. I once remarked that I thought she might have had a larger role in causing the tragedy. She suffered some sort of psychotic episode.
Did I rip his head off? I wanted to. What's left of my brain will explode. Is it mad to pray for better hallucinations? Perhaps I'm fated to expire right here.
So Radcliffe isn't here. So presumably what we just saw there was a memory of going for the rabbit, or I don't know, but he's not here. He has left. All movables and effects are gone, nothing but dust stains and the smell of tobacco. No sign of the coroner's report or my rabbit either. Damn him. So does that mean that... I don't know. Where has Radcliffe gone? Say you've gone quiet. Yes, everything beautiful is gone. Anything at all? Ooh, what was that? I thought I saw something. Why is there snow now? It wasn't snowing a while ago. Alice, what is happening with your head, dear girl? Oh, look. Look who it is. And he's broken out. He's broken out of the globe. Oh. Uh-oh. Here we go back into the visions again. Wonderland. Is that the train? Is intruding upon the real world. Oh, are we in Wonderland or are we in... Let's not go walk through that. Are we in Wonderland or are we in... Yeah. The real world. We appear to be back in Wonderland.
How do you ruin... It's corrupting all of Wonderland.
Seeking refuge from the wicked world? Perhaps things only look like they've gone to hell.
You're not that good a liar, and I'm not that stupid. But something a bit less calamitous would have been welcome.
This unmitigated disaster is your doing, and it will get worse. Your train keeps a hellish schedule. Get moving. Time waits for no one. The change has begun.
The train is perfectly capable of terrifying me, Cat. You should find another job. Is there really so little hope?
There's even less, and if fear paralyzes you, we are lost.
The Veil of Doom. Well, these guys are here to fight, but I don't actually want to fight anybody right now. I think I need to have a break. Is what I need to have. I'll just kill these guys off first. Oh, did you eat a little chunk? I don't think he's actually doing them any damage, but there you go. Come on in, buddy. You and me. Let's get it on. Got a hit on him. Okay. Can I throw something at me now? Here we go. Too soon. Gotcha. Right, time for a break now. I mean, that was a nice little punch up at the end, but time for a break up before we have a little jaunt to the Vale of Doom. That'll be fun. Thanks for watching.